pull the other way, right? So you get that 15 degree angle, and that way it pulls against it, right? All right, yes, what are your strengths? Let's do a 1-to-1.
One-to-one is
1,400.
1,400? Yeah. I'm hearing numbers.
1-to-1, right, sir?
Yep, 1-to-1.
1,400.
One
is 700.
1-to-1.
One picket is 700. 1-to-1 is 1,400.
All right, so 1,400. A 1-1-1. Because we don't do twos, we always do threes. Mm. At least, right? So what's three?
1,800.
All right. 2-to-1?
2,000.
All right. And a 3-to-1. 3-2-1.
4,000.
Because we say 3-to-1, but it's 3-2-1. Right? We just talked about it.
Yes.
Okay? Because it's always a 3, right? You don't go a picket, a picket. It'll be 3 in a row. So you'll either have 1 on the front, a 1 and a 1, or you'll have 2, a 1 and a 1, or a 3, 2 and a 1. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Alright, so let's grab our pick.
The reason why is if I hit that, you can simply, instead of holding that, the tendency is, this. Yeah. So if I miss.
If he misses, he hits and your hand falls away. But you'll never see us do that. We're stubborn Americans, and we like to do it that way. But you just don't hold it tight. Because I'm telling you, if you miss and hit your hand, you better be letting go. Hit it hard. Alright. So how far away does the next one go?
The length of the picket.
The length of a picket. Very good.
Two.
You have to pay attention. I'm not.
Just like this, we'll start making it, send it up to
the
window. Okay.
Yes.
Another piece of rope. We can start on the next one, right? So this is all about saving time, right? There you go. Oh.
Down as low as it go.
Keep wrapping.
What do you say?
So get it wrapped around.
Just like the maze.
I will do that all day.
Just like the maze trailer.
Exactly. Now I'm gonna get the Castro to translate that.
Yes, sir.
He's too busy laughing in front of Lucy's party. Alright. So you get to the end, now what?
Quidditch.
Okay.
That's 4. That's already 4. It's already 4. Nice.
There you go. Alright. So is that done? We're doing this.
We can put.
You need the windlass.
Yep.
And now you gotta tighten it up, right?
So this.
There you go.
Quidditch with a safety knot.
You wrap that?
As long as that it will not pull the integrity of this one.
So you're going to twitch it? Keep twitching it. Twitch it again.
Okay.
Watch. Because see the thing. See, when you see that start to pull down.
Yes, sir.
That's it. Well,
then that's a good one. Okay, so get it to the point. There you go. Because you get that little bit of a pull, and that lets you know you have tension in you.
Okay.
Okay. Now this one, does this one go on an angle or straight up and down?
Straight up.
Straight up and down.
Yes, sir.
Drive that.
Alright.
That's pulling. There you go.
One more.
Alright. Drive that.
This should be
straight up and down.
Straight up.
It goes. Okay. So you figure you have a come along, right?
Yeah.
The come along comes right here, right?
That's it.
And this is going to come along. I'm just putting it there for a visual for y'all. Okay. And that way, and it goes low. And that way, it's pulled in line. Okay. So the object that we're pulling against is over here. Say it's a car or just something we need to stabilize, right? So that's how that goes. Okay. All right. So, this is old school, okay? This is the way we did it for years. I've been in the fire service for over 24 years now, and this is the way we did it when I came in. This is the way they were doing it 20 years before I came in. And guess what? We have new ways to do it, all right? So what we're gonna do, somebody know how to use that ratchet? Anybody else here know how to use a ratchet? The bee's trying to do everything, all right? So that's where.
Questions, sir.
Certainly, I'll answer it.
After I'm finished.
Go ahead.
How do you pull that picket out?
All right, Mr. Pete. Load this.
How are we loaded?
This.
Just the ankle, sir.
Mm-hmm. Drop it here. Bring it to the middle. Then you tie together. And you want the ratchet in the middle. Okay?
We'll just get down to the bottom.
Alright? You pull tension on that. Stop. That's it. Okay. Huh? Really tight. Give me Mr. Moore, grab this thing some more. Let's pick it to this. Yeah. And that's the other thing. If you sit there and drive a
head.
Watch your head. If you drive a picket or you notice that your pickets are loose, drive them further in. It'll further down. Because depending on the soil, if it's real good clay like you have around here,
mm-hmm.
you don't have to drive them until you know so hard and deep, right? So you get pull the tension, and you just take that and drop it.
You drop it?
It's finished.
So
you take the other one, you put it there, and it's finished. It's done. There's no wrap, no windlass. This is it. You have a mechanical advantage. It's done. This is the newer way we've been doing it for about 10 years now.
But this is 2-1 long, sir.
Right.
So this is.
But I mean, you'll turn around and put that other one. Go get the other one. There you go.
So
take
we can provide how much shorter for this only.
No. You're
going to
put that one in here.
Another one.
So
there.
It's the same thing.
Mm.
No, you don't need to. Well, the reason why this is so long is so you can use it elsewhere. Right? Like we use it, we'll go over top of the tank or something like that. But because of the mechanical advantage you gain in this, you don't need. You're gonna take the rope and keep wrapping. You throw this in place, a couple brackets, definitely doesn't slip anymore, it's done. The trick is, you just have to make sure that the ratchet is in the middle. The clips are in the middle. You don't want them on the end, because if the ratchet's up here on the end, you know, you're not getting, you know, it's working against that. So you put them in the middle where there's less tension, or there's the flexibility, should I say. Stop it,
and then pull.
Alright, so bring it around that picket, clip it in. Alright,
crank it.
Pull tension out of that. Before you crank it, you want all the slack out. See all the slack?
Yes, sir.
Drop that down. All that slack out,
right?
Because if you have a lot of slack, this doesn't tend to be, you can see that all in there. And then if it has a whole bunch in there, then it's going to get too big and it'll lock it off. All right, go ahead. Take it all the way over. Yep. Keep going. All right. Let's see how it's got to get it in there. Just stick it. It's too late. Yep. All right.
Good.
Two more from the top. Maybe not stop. And push that down on the bottom. That's it. So instead of doing all the ramps below, you're doing the window. This is it. Take all the rest of this, throw it on the ground beside. Pull it up underneath it, keep it out of the way, but it's worth it.
This is rated for 4,000 pounds. This can hold a car?
Yeah. Absolutely. Come in here at the bottom?
Yeah.
You click in here at the bottom because you figure.
If that's in.
Not under that. It's really under.
Figure this is a chain.
Sir.
Right? It comes around, right?
And I tie it to the other end.
Then you go to the car and come along and tighten that up. That ain't moving. Pull the car over. If that car is sitting on its side, and I put a come along on this, the whole car gets pulled over.
Okay.
Believe me, done that one.